Hey, Jeff Howard here at kiteboarding.com and wingboarding.com. So we've got a lot of questions of people coming in and they're asking us, what board size should I get? How should I start to get into wingboarding? Well, I gotta tell you, you definitely wanna get something in the larger size when you're learning. If you can go to a lesson area and learn using their larger size boards, that is a massive benefit. But if you don't and you're gonna start learning where you are or you have a crew, you guys can get together, pick up a large board, because you're gonna downgrade to the right size board for you after you learn. And it does help having that larger board and larger type foils to learn to get into the sport. It stabilizes everything if you haven't been foiling before. So it's gonna have a little bit of trickiness getting into it if you haven't foiled before. But board size, I wanna talk about a little bit of board shaping. Not a whole lot because there's so much shaping into it and the reason behind it, but it's mainly about the board size to get into. So what I have here, this is a Slingshot Wingcraft. This is a 120 liter board. We have found out, we go out and we teach a lot of people. I've taught people that are well over 200 pounds all the way down to the small guys in the 150 range. Having a large size board like this, what it does is it gives you, allows you to practice the technique of handling the wing. If you're messing with a small board, always fighting to keep your balance, it's very frustrating to learn those techniques, which is very important, is wing control, where to position the wing, because you're falling off continuously. Having a large board in a 120 liter, 125 liter, that's what we found pretty much essential to getting people out and getting into the sport and learning it. Having that allows you flotation. You're in most cases allowed to crawl up on the board. Don't have any kind of wing abilities or power in the wing at all. You can stand up on this thing, kind of like an SUP type board. Practice that balance that you need. You can start out on your knees, then you get up onto your feet and keep and practice that balance. It also, what a lot of people don't understand what a large board does, is it slows down the reaction of the foil. So that allows a person to understand what's happening with that foil and get you slowly involved into the foiling side of it. The longer it is, the more that foil has to lift that board or make the foil react, or wants to react, the board just slows all that down. So once you get past and get into your turns, you will see that these boards are very, very cumbersome in coming around in the turn. But when you get started, having something in that 125, 100, 120, 125, 130, those are really big boards. But that's what you want to learn to get out in to get control. Now, when I talk about a little bit of shaping, some of these larger size boards, as well as other ones, the shaping, what they'll do is you'll see these long sides on them here, these angled sides, and they're really long. It's real thick to give you that buoyancy. Well, what that does is when you have the weight on the board, the water comes up and more of the board is in the water, causing more stability. As you begin in motion, it quickly picks up and the water line now moves into these smaller areas, decreasing the surface area tension, which gets that up on plane. Now, the main difference that you'll find between a large board and a smaller size board is it's really hard to rock and pump the foil to get it to come up. So getting up on a large board, it's mainly the power you have in your wing and the pumping of your wing, finding the balance point where you're going to be positioned on that to be able to get up on that board. It will basically foil on its own. When I'm out there teaching a person, I will tell them just stay upwind. Learn to practice staying upwind. You don't have to be on foil using the large board. Get that technique down. Once that happens, then you will go into getting the wing up, starting the foil, and then learning to handle that foil and the balance of that foil. That's what you want to get into. Now, once you do learn to get up on it, be consistent, get some good turns, practice getting your turns, your jibes on both directions, switching your feet. Larger boards are a little slower and allow you to practice that feet position and motion. Then you'll move down to a different size board. This is a 75 liter. This is my all-around average board, but I did step down from a 120. I quickly went down to a 90. I practiced on the 90. Then I started practicing learned techniques to ride on a 75. And then that put me into the area where I'm out there sailing a lot. It's easy for me to still get up on, but it also allows my foil to have a lot of action to it. Then you go into what a lot of people are calling the sinkers. This is a 40 liter board. and it is very small. What happens here is you definitely want to be highly powered on these. You want to do a lot of practicing on this. These are sinkers. They will sink under the water, and they're like balancing on a bobber. And once you get them in motion, once you get the technique, which is in some of my other videos, then you're able to get up, and these are really make your foil very active and a lot of fun. There are guys that can go down on a lot of smaller ones. I've seen them out there. It's amazing. It's a really cool technique. But as an all-around average board, I sit at about the 75. 75 is really comfortable for me. I'm about 165 to 170 pounds. I can get up on it in waves. I can get up and chop. I can deal with that. And definitely makes it a lot easier. But when you come into foil-sized boards, when you want to get into the wing boarding, definitely start out on something large. If you have any questions, don't ever hesitate. Give us a call, because we're happy to put that information in there, find the right size foil, get the right size board out there for you, and try to see if we can hand you over some of those techniques. Anyway, that's Jeff Howard here at kiteboarding.com and wingboarding.com to share some information on what size board is best for you to get started.